Hello and welcome to the next part of our tutorial series. Here we are creating a game in a third person view, like a survival game. In the last part we have bring our rifle to it. So let's see here. That's for the moment, but we cannot aiming, we can not going in a shoulder view. So in this part we will bring us first the shoulder view to it, and then we will bring the aiming to it, so we can aim, can look down and look up with our weapon. That is what we are doing. In the next part, we will customize this, we will polish this a little bit. And when we are finished with that, we starting with shooting. So we create here a little enemy when we can shoot his down, so he will die. That is the plan. But for now we will starting, I think the good solution is we start with the shoulder view. So I have opened my other project to see the settings. So at the moment we have here the third person fix it. That is that what we have created, and what we are here, the third person fix it, what we are enabled at the moment. But we need other third person fix it. We going here, third person fix it, and on the plus icon make add a motor new here and call it aiming. So that's it. Looking in my object here, I have here this. So, and the first is what we are setting up is not the rig encore. We will use the player in that. Yeah, later we will set it up with a variable here, so that will change it instant. So as next we must have an offset, that is for the shoulder view. I use here 0.75. Make here the height from 1.5. Collision is enabled, fade is disabled. Now we come to jaw and to the pitch values. So for this we make here for jaw 75, and for the pitch we have 45. That's okay. And we have a smoothing from 0.05. It's okay, but we need a distance from 1. So collision is okay, that it's enabled. So let me see when we enabled it. So we're starting our project at the moment. Here we stand in the rifle animation, and now when I make here on the plus, on the fix it, we are here in our shoulder view, but you see here that must be fixed. Yeah, that looks not so good at the moment. Yeah, okay. So the next is I have create here a little quad to it. Yeah, so that is the next what we are bringing here, our main camera, create a 3D object quad. So this will the point is what will we do with it. This point will be our crosshair later. So you have two options. This options is create a quad, and from this quad we're sending up a raycast. The other option is create a crosshair in the canvas and take from this world position the raycast to the object. But that is for me the best solution was with a quad here. And we make it 0.01, and here again And from the Z exit, so when I looking here is our quad, and here is our camera. I will make 0.1, and we have it a little bit more forward, yeah. So that's here, and now we create a material. You see here, I use this material. I have here the laser impulse flare. This is really easy. You create a picture with this solution, 128 and 128. Can you make in GIMP, or I make it later self, and then you bring here a little blue circle to it. So for now we will create a material that is interesting. You can use other material. Important is I make aiming crosshair the name. Important for this is it must be black. Yeah, you can make a crosshair or a circle, a white circle on a black screen. So, and now we're looking here for that material. So we're looking here for the legacy shader, and then for particles additive. Yeah, that is what we are looking for. So we're going here and make it to white. Yeah, that is the same what we are here having, and then you can put your picture to it, and then you have this here, and we're going to our quad, and you see we have here a point on it. So that is our crosshair for shooting. So, and as next we must bring some FSM to it. You see I have here many actions here in it. Yeah, you see when we are in aiming, this quad here will enable it and bring it to the camera motor and so on. When we are on aim, and for aiming is this, and I think that is what we are creating as first. The aiming will control from the main camera. Yeah, so I minimize this, and now we're looking for a playmaker script, and we call it aiming. Yeah, and here we will start for aiming. So I make it a little bit bigger. Yeah, so first event is start fast. So, and we're going here the global to it. The next is riffle, next event riffle, aim, and then riffle in aiming. So bring it here, riffle aim is set. That is when we are not pressed the right mouse button, and when we are pressing the right mouse button, we going here. So the first thing is he looking for the animator layer weight, yeah, or he set it up at the moment. Yeah, so when we are looking here on our animator, so let me see here in our player model, the animator is here, we have the riffle upper body. So, and at the moment this is on 1, we can make it to 0, and when we are going out from the riffle aiming, we will have it 0, or when we are later use upper weapons, then must be 0. The upper weapon like pistol have a upper body, and bow have the same upper body. Yeah, so but back to it. So at the first here, set layer weight, set animator layer weight. So, and here we're looking for our animator model, what we are have creating. So, and you see in this is 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So for this, we must setting up, let's go into back to playmaker, layer index is 1. Yeah, And then the layer weight is 0. Yeah, we make it every frame. Okay. So, okay. So, that is what I later came. And we're looking for other for int compare, and that is what we are seeing, what we are creating, what we must create. We're going here to our weapon holder. And let me see, not the head. This was here in the right hand here. That is at the moment our test rifle. And we have only set it up here, our IK hands, that is okay. Was on our last tutorial. And, but for now we must bring here other FSM, yeah? So we can here add FSM, new FSM. And this will, the rifle system, this come later, but for the moment, we will up set Integra value. So we create a new global. And this will be weapons Integra, yeah? And this is one for our rifle. For pistol, we will make two, and for bow, we make three. Yeah, so we create a little catalog for this. So, okay. Then we go back to the main camera, going here. And now we're looking for Integra compare. That's here. So, and now we're looking what we are creating, the weapon Integra. So we have set it up at the moment, the zero. And when the, when it one and equal, then going to rifle aim every frame. Yeah. So when our weapon Integra is one, he going here in Z, and here we bring the right mouse key to rifle aim and back again. Yeah, but that is at the moment what we are will bring here. So let's see. So here we are at the moment. And now you see our weapon Integra is one, and then we're going to rifle aim. So the problem is at the moment, we're going here to our import stuff, what we are have creating. And on a character window, and we're looking here for our here on this, yeah. And we must set up here our weapon Integra to zero. That is important. So when we are not more have the weapon Integra, also not more the rifle in it, the weapon Integra will be zero. That must setting up here. So let me see here. It's the same. So you see here set Integra value weapon Integra with zero is the same later for the Integra for the weapons, yeah. So you have questions how we can make from idle, from non-weapon idle to in rifle idle, and so that come in the next tutorial. The problem is we have a skill bar here in our game. So and on the skill bar, not at the moment I think. We have here the skill bar, and the problem is when we will here at slot 1 we have the pistol, slot 2 the player put it, the bow and so on, the other weapons to it, and he press 1 or 2, we will change the weapon instantly. We will not put the weapon back to the backpack or something like that. And wait, the new weapon, he put it out. We will create more faster and more flexibility. Yeah, we will use the skill bar for weapons instantly. We can say, okay, we press 2, we have the pistol, we press 1, we have instantly the rifle. Not this, we put the weapon back and so on. Yeah, you cannot bring it in, but my experience is on the end, it's not yeah, that's not the best way. Yeah. The problem is when you have a team who you can create animations for you and so, then you can bring it in, then that is no problem. But when you have not the animation or you use Kubot animation, then it's a problem. What is when you have melee weapons and so on, that looks not so good. So that is why I not use for a weapon equip and unequip animations for that. So I will use instantly from the skill bar, can changing. So, but back yet to the character window. So we're going here to this and we will setting up here set integer value. So, and that is when the weapon not more is equipped. Yeah. So, then it's zero. Okay. So let's see. And I'm going back to our main camera. It's here. And oh wait, we must setting up here. We copy this. Pass it here. And when it's zero, then going back to start fast. Yeah. The same like later here. Yeah, it's zero, go back to start fast. Okay, so let's test it. So here we are. So I equip my weapon. Okay, we are here at the moment. We cannot going in aiming. And now when I put it back, you see we going back in start fast. Yes, we are standing at the moment here. That is, we have not the transition from idle to from rifle idle to non-weapon idle. Yeah, but that come later. Okay, that's it. So now we must bring our right click aiming to it. Yeah, so when we are here, that is later the component for the IK aim, for the final IK what we are looking. So and at the moment you see we have here loot at normal, so that is what we are must creating later. So I think we create this for now. So when we are going to our look at here, so we going back here, look at, that is what we are creating, and now we make normal and we make aim. Yes, so give here that is normal, and now we create a new global position with aim here to it, and in aim we use the smooth look at. Yeah, the smooth look at not this here, smooth look at, and with the smooth look at we have here in the look at direction, a target direction, a vector 3. And in the smooth look at, we have here a target. Yes, so we can bring here our quad. Yeah, how we will looking, but better solution is we create a new empty game object under the main camera, make it here on a z-axis with 10, see it here, and we set look at. So and then we say look to this, and here we make none and we make 15 here, and that's it. Yeah, and that is here our aiming. Yeah, so back to the main camera here. So here in this action is send event by name. So and at the first we're looking for the game object FSM, a specific game object what we are looking, and that is our player. So and here we must put it in look at, no, normal, nein, look at, it's right, that is the FSM name here, that is that, and the send event is normal and not delay to it. Yeah, so it's the same like what we have here. Yeah, look at normal, that's okay. So and now we copy this And we passed the edge in here. We passed it over that. And now we say here aim here. When we are in aim, he going in this for aiming. So that is. And for now, we will bring creating now that we can aim. And here we get mouse button. Bring it here. And here we're looking for the right mouse button, yeah? And we create a new variable aim. And or we can, yeah, we make it as global. I think that's better. Delete it, yes. And here new global variable is aim. And then we're looking bool all true. So that is a bool variable what we are have creating. And now we looking here for the global aim. And when it's true, when we are pressed the right mouse button, then go in riffle aiming. So we copy this function, we need it here again, past action before. And now we're looking for non-true. Yeah. So, and we put it here and we set it up here back to riffle aim every frame and global aim. Yeah, so that is every frame. Okay, so let's see. So we are here putting our weapon in it and now I press the right mouse key. So, and you see, we are follow. It, yes, we follow the look at the moment. So make it okay. And then I go forward. That's okay. So, but we must setting up a little bit more here in it. And at the first is what we are will setting up is the animator layer white. We copy this here, pass the action before, and we going here, pass action before, and here now we set layer white to 1. Yeah, that is we will have the upper body to it. Yeah. So after we have doing this, we have doing this all, and for now, we will setting up our camera motor. Yeah. So for this, we're going back to the main camera here, and add new FSM, and we call it camera motor. So, and here we have only two. The first is start fast, and the second will be aim. So this motor will give us a bridge from our playmaker to our camera controller. Yeah, so here this and here this. Okay. So at the first is here our quad. So we make set property. We can use this as a child from the main camera. So we must not look for get component and set property. We can use it instantly, put it in this. So we make active. At the moment, this will not be active here. We copy this. And when we are here in aiming, then will be active. Okay. So the next is we're looking for a bool all true. So we're looking here for our aim. So and when this is true, he's going to aim. And now we're looking here for a non-true, bool non-true. 1 and going back to our start fast. Yeah, so that is what we are doing here. This. So now we can disable it for the moment and we remove the mesh collider. So, now we are here, we putting our weapon in it, now we can go and aim. So, and we see here, I think it's a little bit hard to see, but we see here, when I press not more right, we see not more our aiming, and when I press right key, we see our aiming crosshair. Okay, that's it. So, and the next is what we are need. We will now setting up our camera motor, yeah? So, for this, we create here a object, call it camera motor. And for this, we must looking, we searching it here. Com, OT, camera, camera controller, yeah, that is what we are looking for. Okay, then we're looking for get component. Then the camera motor, every frame, use owner, it's right. We are here on it. Here, and here is our component, yes. So and now we're looking for a set property. Set property. So make it under this, and now for the camera motor, we're looking for here for mode, yeah, and at the moment we have here, you see zero. Okay, that's right, that is zero, and we copy this two actions, we passed the actions here, move over that. And we will in aiming going in this mode have one. Here's zero and here is one. So, okay. Let's see. So we're standing here and we need here our weapon. And you see, for now, I'm here in it. But we cannot aiming at the moment, yeah? We cannot aim with our weapon. And that is what we will ask next doing. For this I use Final IK. Final IK is at the moment in the store for the half price. So and for this to setting up it, we going to our animation model. You see, I have set it up here. So and at the first I looking the full body Bippet IK. That is the first what I looking for it, and I move it up. So that's okay. So and here it's important to make 0.01 fix transform. It's okay. He put all the bones in this instantly here. See it? That's okay. And the next is what we are need. The next component is aim IK. Yeah. So we move it up. So, and for here, we bring here our look at to it. That is from the main camera. And for the aim transform, we make here for testing the test riffle. So that we can see how it works. So and now we must create here some bones to it. So I think I have here 5 bones. So, okay. At the first bone is the hips. See it here. And we make the hips with a weight from 0.5. Yeah, that is the first. So the next will be the spine. One, spine two, spine 3, yeah, and the last will be our clavicle right here. That's it. So and for the other settings we make here at the moment, we make it 0 and that's okay. Okay, I think the settings are good. So, I started. And now you see no aiming at the moment, and when I press here to it, you see it cannot go up and down, but when I bring the weight up here, you see, I can look up and down. So I maximize, you see it better in on maximize, and then that is. But in the next tutorial we will bring it to Playmaker, so we have better setting when I not more press right key. You see, looking here, that's not good. Yeah, that is not the idea what we have for it. And the other problem is when I bring up, when I looking up or when I looking down, you see my left hand. Yeah, for this we I have a little script from the outer, from the final IK. I will upload it in the next tutorial. That is what we are using. So, and that is what we are bring in the next tutorial. When we time have in the next tutorial, we will bring in for the walking. So at the moment we can only walk forward and backward, and when I press left, you see I'm full time in the forward, not in the in that blend tree what we are have creating. But I can wait, I can make something. Let me go in here, but we make aim on. So now we are here in aiming, our aiming tree. And but we must setting up. You see this problem is we have not setting up our get axis input for this tree. That is the next what we are must doing. But that's not problem. So. But you see you have a clean aiming that looks really really good, and that is the final IK. You can create this cool aiming to it. It's really really good, save us a lot of time. And yeah, that's it for this at the moment. And yeah, see you on the next time. I hope that helped you. I hope you understand that here all, and yeah, in the next part we will creating the bridge from the final IK to the Playmaker. We will creating here then that we can walking around and so on. That come all in the next tutorials, in the next parts. So stay tuned. That's from my side. I'm out. Bye bye.